catastrophic contagion, one that could kill tens, even thousands of millions. Are we prepared?
Mi ha chiamata perché da qualche giorno che Arianna ha un po' di febbre, un po' di mal di pancia, è sempre debole.
Niente, ero sotto casa e un tipo ubriaco mi ha aggredita.
Il morbo di Gerber è una sindrome infettiva sostenuta da un virus. Non ci sono aspettative di tornare ad una vita normale.
Stasera verrete con me e potrete vedere come lavoro. Andrò a vigilare su una zona che mi hanno dato.
Will it continue to cause lots of illnesses, and will many of those illnesses be very severe? If that all happens, then we are literally sitting at the doorstep of the next pandemic.
I haven't been in this area long, but you seem to not be infected, but we should probably keep moving. Are you hurt at all?
An animal virus that can infect humans, something for which humans have no immunity.
Just how serious an outbreak could get, you won't want.
You know, there's a popular movie out now called Contagion that takes a look at what would happen if a highly contagious and deadly virus got loose in the world. But is this realistic? I'm Dr. Andy Martin, and let's go visit with a disease detective at the Center for Disease Control and Prevention and find out more.
We are basically, we're called CDC's disease detectives. So when CDC sends people out into the field to respond to a public health emergency, it's typically the EIS officers who are either leading those teams or definitely part of those teams.
Doug, the public might be confused between a contagious disease and an infectious disease. What's the difference?
An agent can be infectious, but the ability to cause severe disease is different. In the movie, there is an agent that is highly contagious. It's infectious from person to person, and it causes really severe disease.
In the movie, this virus goes crazy. It's highly infectious. Goes in 120 days, I think a billion people are infected. Is that possible?
Well, I think in the modern world, it's absolutely possible because we no longer live in little communities. We're connected. You can get infected as the movie did in one country and be in another country 5 hours later. So we live in a global community, and diseases that impact, you know, Africa no longer just impact Africa. They impact us too.
How do we get new viruses? I mean, are they always out there and we come in contact with them?
I think there are different theories about that. Viruses like the influenza virus are very susceptible to rearranging. So if two different strains of virus infect the same person, they can mix up their genetic material and make a different virus.
Doug, in this movie, fear takes over. It actually becomes more contagious than the virus. Do you see fear as being a major thing where information, the proper information, is important to combat that?
I think you've hit on a really critical point, and that is getting information out to the public that is timely and that is accurate. And that's a big part of what CDC tries to do. If you look at what happened during H1N1, CDC had daily press briefings where they updated the public on exactly how many cases there had been and where they were.
Since travel was a big part of the spread of this disease and 3 million people travel daily, what should people do to keep themselves healthy when they travel?
For transmission of respiratory, you know, breathing pathogens like they had in this movie, things like washing your hand, be careful, you know, what you touch. And I think it's different at different times of the year. I don't go out today and wash my hands every 5 minutes. In flu season, if I'm dealing with a lot of people, I actually may use a hand sanitizer. So I think your level of precaution needs to be appropriate for the level of risk.
For HealthWatch MD, I'm Dr. Randy Martin.
Measles is said to be the most contagious disease on Earth. If one person has measles, they can affect 15 at any given time. But Dr. Oz says measles is making a comeback in this country because he believes it's because kids are not getting vaccinated. Now, I've already told you why. When most believe it is from people who have not complied with the government rules and have eliminated their children from being vaccinated like everyone else. Or, you know, it's those foreigners. Well, all this is a lie. In my links, I have provided a link that states that the MRR vaccines cause measles. Open your eyes wide and know what is going on around you fully. Manufactured smallpox. Francis Townsend from CNN says the ability to use a very small sample and use it in a method of mass destruction is tremendous. The CDC lab is one of only two labs in the world that has legal samples of smallpox viruses. If it was a smallpox attack, the CDC says it could control it. Do we really trust our government people? Oh yes, they can control it. They've been controlling it so far. Look around. Dr. Tom Friedman of the novel swine flu genes says that it can also be a pandemic of the H1N1 because it is combining with the swine flu gene that it infects humans. Several kids have already gotten infected with it, but unfortunately, they're all fine and have recovered. This was being talked about in one of the clips that I just played you. So far, there hasn't been any spread from person to person, and the CDC lab have already made a vaccine strain so that if it begins to spread, they can begin to make a vaccine production. Now, Dr. Oz tells you to get your flu shot. For flu shots, this is what he said on his show that I was watching, will protect you. Now, I've provided a link below that proves flu shots vaccines revealed as the greatest quackery ever pushed in history of medicine. People to be protected from flu or a cold, and many other diseases, all you need to take is vitamin D3. No flu shot. That's a lie. Let me play a clip here what Dr. Oz says about his own family on that.
Telling a mother who is trying to decide myself whether to get my kids vaccinated when the time comes, and I'm reading this, 51% of parents, only 51% are absolutely certain. I'll be honest, I'm in that 50% that isn't absolutely certain. So how do you convince me? How do you convince the other parents out there that we need to do this?
Campbell, I'm going to get it.
Yes.
If that helps at all, but I'll tell you, my wife is not getting immunized as our kids because I've got four of them, and when I go home, I'm not Dr. Oz, I'm Mr. Oz.
I wonder why he says that about his own family, because he knows the truth. There's a link in the box to a vaccine exception form online for every state or county. Please check them out in the box below because they're knocking on your door. Next clip.
Hello, how are you, ma'am? My name's Heyman Matlock. I'm with the Thomas Unified School District.
It's not easy going door to door making sure students are vaccinated.
Your daughter is on independent study.
Yeah.
Kayla, has she been verified with her Tdap?
No.
Okay. We were coming today to give her a Tdap if she hasn't had it done yet.
Get the off my house. Hey, Miss Matlock, dealing with a lot of sticky situations. Despite weeks of free clinics and warnings, some Natomas kids still have not received a shot for whooping cough.
There could be some family dynamics where they're having hardships in the home, and this isn't the top priority in them making it day to day. Hello, this is Heyman Matlock with the Thomas Unified School District.
He has a list of more than 40 left to get vaccinated, so with a traveling nurse on hand, district officials are now left to track down kids who may be falling through the cracks.
There are a number of kids that we're finding out in our home visit today that are truant. They aren't in school, so this also gives us an opportunity to find out where those kids are that have truancy issues.
Truant kids and negligent parents are put on notice. The Natomas district is going to extremes and putting up with extremes to keep kids from getting sick.
Get the f***ers off my house.
Well, kids won't be allowed back to school Monday if they haven't been vaccinated. The district will continue door-to-door visits until...
Dr. Oz told us that we need to wash our hands, guard ourselves from pathogens. This is very true. Use your discernment. But while I was listening, I heard the ones with the seal in their forehead shall not be touched. That means if you have the seal of the Holy Ghost, this will pass over you. But be wise. In other words, use your wisdom. If you don't have it, you need to pray for it. Remember John G. Lake, he put germs in his hand and they would die, but he had the faith that they would. Dr. Oz said the film Contagion is the first Hollywood movie that gets it right. He thinks that it is possible that it would happen within our lifetime. Dr. Oz spoke with director Steven Spielberg on his show. He told Spielberg that after he left the theater, it seemed like everything was in slow motion. He noticed someone was coughing across the street and thought about what if they were patient zero, and he described how patient zero would be unaware that they were sick or contagious and would be a carrier of a deadly virus as she goes about her daily activity. He paints a scenario of a patient zero walking across Manhattan and stopping at an ATM machine. She would pass a germ on to the buttons on the ATM, thus leaving behind her the germ that would become infection for someone else. This virus would quickly spread throughout Manhattan, soon infecting thousands of people that would be out of control throughout New York City. Dr. Oz said, this movie, the fear and the breakdown of society of it actually took place, would be fiction, and the base of the movie coming out, the premises of the movie is one that can actually happen. I'm telling you, they're setting you up for what they are doing. For movies, commercials, and cartoons, like I've told you before, everything they do, everything they make, is just preparing you for what is ahead. Now,